गुड मॉर्निंग, दिस इज मिसेस शांति, टीजीटी इंग्लिश ऑफ केवी अशोकनगर, ब्रिंगिंग यू द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ द पोएम डस्ट ऑफ स्नो, रिटन बाय रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट फ्रॉम द बुक फर्स्ट फ्लाइट ऑफ क्लास 10. डियर स्टूडेंट्स, यू आर ऑलरेडी एक्वेंटेड विद द पोएट रॉबर्ट फ्रॉस्ट थ्रू हिज पोएम द रोड नॉट टेकन फ्रॉम क्लास 9 इंग्लिश रीडर. About Robert Frost. Robert Frost was a famous American poet. He was born in San Francisco on March 26, 1874. His father belonged to New England and his mother was a Scottish emigrant from Edinburgh. By 1920s, Frost was the most celebrated poet in America. He is also a recipient of the Pulitzer Prize. First, let me recite the poem. The way a crow shook down on me, the dust of snow from a hemlock tree, has given my heart a change of mood and saved some part of a day I had rued. So, the poem starts in a very dull and gloomy state. The tone is sad and depressing. The poem is set in a scene where the poet is in a bad mood and is walking by a tree, a hemlock tree, which is poisonous and has small white flowers. As he passes by, a crow happens to throw some snow dust on him. Whether it falls on his head or shoulders is unknown, as there is no specific mention in the poem. Also, the readers are left in doubt about the bird's specific action. Whether the crow was landing, shivering with twisting itself on the branch, or taking off, it happened to send some particles of snow upon the author. Here, the two agents of nature, the hemlock tree and the crow, are signifiers of sadness and gloom, just like the poet's mood was in the opening scene. For reasons unknown, the poet was having a terrible day, but the falling of the snow on his head lifted his mood instantly. He had already spent his day, but the rest of it was saved by the crow and the hemlock tree. Generally, hemlock tree and crow are used for negative references, but the poet used them beautifully to portray that inauspicious things can bring joy and happiness too. One must not take things for granted and should be open and accept whichever way the nature chooses to bless us. In this poem, we see that a very trivial and small incident in his life brings about a big transformation in his mood. We then proceed to the gist of the poem. Dust of Snow is a beautiful poem written by the poet Robert Frost. It depicts a simple moment, but it has great significance. The poet is depressed and has lost all hope in the beginning of the lines. He is sitting under a hemlock tree. A small incident changes his sad mood. The poem teaches us that one should never be desperate and hopeless. The theme of the poem. The poet beautifully illustrates the extraordinary curative power of nature and trivial things in life. Nature cures everything, whether it is awful mood or illness. But one should be observant and ready to accept experiencing one such bad day when a crow's movement near hemlock dusted snow upon him. The snow instantly makes him happier. What value does the poem impart? A positive change can happen even through the so-called inauspicious or ill-omened things. A trivial, insignificant things too can create a huge difference in our life. Simple acts of kindness done can inspire others with enthusiasm and may bring huge changes in their life. Let us proceed to the poetic devices in the poem. Let's take the first one, symbolism. The crow represents small and trivial things in life. The snow represents things that can affect our mood. We then have the alliteration. Alliteration is the use of consonant sounds in the same line. We have save and some. We then proceed on to the synecdoche, a figure of speech in which a part is made to represent the whole or vice versa. It is used where the poet said his heart and in mood, which actually represents his entire personality. The poem follows ABAB rhyming scheme. And the poem, though it began with a pessimistic tone, ends with an optimistic tone. There are a few extracts with solved answers which you may go through it. And then you have two questions which have appeared in the board examination. One is a 2 marks question and one is an 8 marks question, a value-based question. There are times when we feel depressed and hopeless. We think that things will never change. Suddenly a change comes in our mood when cheerfulness replaces the sense of regret. Justify the above statement in the context of the poem, Dust of Snow. Always remember, children, in order to impress and give a fine presentation, you start with a quote or you end with a quote suitable for the question. In this particular answer, I have begun, quote, look deep into nature, you will understand everything better. And then we go on to an infographic which brings you the entire poem in a nutshell. You have the poetic devices, you have the theme of the poem, you have the imagery and tone of the poem, a short summary of the poem, and the rhyme scheme. You can use this before you proceed for your examination, which will be very useful as a part of revision. Thank you.